Breaking news and weather, top of the hour to you on this Friday morning on AMHQ. And wait till you see these pictures if you're just waking up. What a morning we have been through. This is a massive blaze in Louisville, Kentucky, possibly touched off by a lightning strike as storms moved through very early this morning, leading to flooding. Now, the fire department there is saying that it's a massive fire. This building is the size of at least 10 football fields. That thick black smoke is moving out of that area and being reported at the airport in Louisville, at least 4 miles away. Falling ash and smoke reported at the airport. This is a big problem as a cold front will move through the area later on tonight with possibly more in the way of storms and some strong gusty winds. So, raging floodwaters along with that this morning. Just imagine what it was like to wake up in Louisville, Kentucky at about 2 a.m. being forced to evacuate from your home and look into the parking lot and seeing your cars, filled with water all the way up to the headlights and beyond. Over 100 water rescues in that water overnight into the early morning hours. And Jim, we've tracked those storms all morning long for people moving a little bit to the south of that area and east.
Yeah, and it doesn't look like this fire is coming down anytime soon. So what we're watching is the change in wind now a little bit more southerly, bringing that plume potentially back up toward the city of Louisville.
Yeah, and Jim, I think it's a good point to bring up here. We don't know what was in that building. GE says it's a storage building, but I think it's just good to be wary of the smoke in that area until someone confirms what's in there.
Absolutely, and now that rain's going to come back down over there, I mean, we're probably seeing some of this falling out as kind of black mud from the sky. Sam, let's go and look at this radar because I think this is really awesome. We watched the thunderstorms move through this morning, and then, of course, left behind was this signature, and you're like, no question, that is the fire in the smoke. And look at what's happened here. We've seen it spread to the west with the southeast wind and now begin to turn as it begins to disperse a little bit and get now ahead of the main cold front. So the winds are going to come more southerly, but notice what that's doing to the smoke. It's bringing it back up toward Audubon Park and potentially into downtown Louisville. And of course, with now new rain coming through that, we're probably going to see some of that ash solidify with the raindrops and fall out of the sky. So let's go back earlier this morning because the area, of course, that we're in question down and through here in terms of where the fire is, look at the lightning. I mean, ladies and gentlemen, we didn't have one or two strokes here. We had about a few dozen. And these are all ground strokes. So a nasty situation here with the flooding as well as what we had going on with the fire. And it's kind of interesting now that Brandon's played this loop a little bit longer, you'll notice this little feature right here dropping onto the south, almost like a little gravity wave that came on through and pretty much cleaned this area out. But now we've got a fire, now we've got rain coming down, and we can see very, very dense smoke working its way all the way up now to the southern part of the city limits of Louisville. So just a horrible situation here with the fire as well as the smoke for those that have to deal with that. All right, so what's gonna happen here in time? Again, a long loop of the two areas that we are left with now. This second one will be the primary area in terms of heavy rain and probably some initial severe weather, I think, this afternoon across parts of central Tennessee and northern Alabama. There may actually be two waves because behind that, we actually have the cold front, which has come on through St. Louis now. And we'll continue to charge on down to the south. And as it does, we'll have a wave of thunderstorms with that. So wave number one is with this first thunderstorm complex moving through southeast Missouri and western Kentucky. Wave number two will be with the cold front itself. And these are the areas that we're highlighting with severe today. Again, wind and hail are the primary threats with a smaller threat of a tornado. But remember, severe thunderstorms can and will, if they choose, to produce tornadoes. So as the cold front continues to charge to the southeast, we just continue to pump up the warm, moist air in through here. So 2 days ago, we didn't have a lot. Now we've got so much that we can't do a lot with it until we can get this cold front through because we're squeezing out tremendous amounts of rain. Currently, seeing some more rain coming back into Louisville. I don't think we're going to deal with another flash flood situation here. It looks like that secondary complex is coming to the south, but it will cause some of this ash and whatever is in that ash to fall out of the sky as kind of a black mud. So that's what you're going to have to deal with in the Louisville area. Again, Lexington starting to see your flood threat move off toward the east. Watch out in Charleston. Watch out down in Pikeville, the beautiful eastern hills of Kentucky. You will be dealing with this as well. Waves of very heavy rain moving through London and Corbin right now, heading over toward Pikeville and southwest Virginia as well. Here's what's left of that thunderstorm complex, Sam. It's a little line echo wave, as we call it. Right now, sub-severe, but we will watch the southern side of this today as it gets into warm, moist air across Tennessee because it has a chance of kicking off more thunderstorms as well. Wave number one of two 2 today for Tennessee, Alabama, and Mississippi.
All right, and that lightning active in Paducah, also Murray, Kentucky, working into Tennessee right now. Jim Cantore, we'll watch it. You know we will. Hey, let's move back into that Louisville situation, because imagine waking up in Louisville and the first thing you dealt with was the flooding rain at about 2 o'clock in the morning and being evacuated. Then the next thing, you had a major fire burning south of Louisville. So let's check in with Louisville Emergency Services' Jody Duncan this morning. Hey, Jody, you've been right on it this morning, giving us all the information possible. Let's talk about this first. As we look at the Louisville fire, just quickly check me up on the roads this morning due to flooding. Do we still have a lot of the traffic backups and some road closures?
We do have road closures, traffic backups. The water rescues are going down a little bit since this rain has subsided and some of the water is receding. But now we have have the fire over here at General Electric that is...
I'm sure it's absorbing a lot of your time, so let's talk about that. This is a massive complex. It's one of GE's largest plant areas now, and we know that this is Building 6. Do we know how many buildings are in that complex?
The information that we have is just that one building. Apparently, they were using that building for storage, that's all of the information that we have on that.
We're all very interested to know what was being stored in that building, as I'm sure the residents around Louisville are, and what you're telling me is you don't have that information. But are you monitoring the air quality around that area right now with a massive fire like that, Jody?
We most certainly are. And actually, we had put out a city notification on our notification system to remind people that there is a fire there. There's no hazard to the public, yet residents with respiratory issues should avoid smoky areas. So just because of the smoke, we want to make sure residents that do have breathing problems or have issues in that area, that they don't get in the smoky areas. So, but we have no hazards as of yet to the public.
All right, and Jody, I just want to confirm, the alarm number on this fire, as we know it right now, is...
It's a 6 alarm. We've got two different, our suburban fire district and our Louisville fire district working it. Louisville fire considered it 2 alarm because of the equipment that they've sent. Mm-hmm. And suburban fire districts are sending it as a 4 alarm. So put those together and it's a 6 alarm fire.
Yeah, absolutely. We had heard some of the many numbers attributed to that. But all right, Jody Duncan, thank you so much of the Louisville Emergency Services PIO, keeping an eye on the situation in Louisville, Kentucky, and all the storms that are in the country as well. As you get up and moving this morning, we also want to mention that there are some wind advisories. That's important to know when you're looking at an area like Kentucky with that smoke, but also important to know is as these storms clear out, big changing wind, we're going to cooler temperatures, even into the Northeast. We'll have all those stories after your local.
It took James Dyson 5,000 prototypes to invent the bagless vacuum, and another 10,000 to invent the only vacuum that doesn't lose suction. Thanks to patented Sonic Tips, everything else is history. Search Kinetic now.
You can't predict the market. But at T. Rowe Price, we've helped guide our clients through good times and bad. Our experienced investment professionals are one reason over 85% of our mutual funds beat their 10-year Lipper averages. So in a variety of markets, we can help you feel confident. Request a prospectus or summary prospectus with investment information, risks, fees, and expenses to read and consider carefully before investing. Call us or your advisor. T. Rowe Price. Invest with confidence.
Need new tires? Right now at Pep Boys, when you buy 3 Falcon, Cooper, or Hankook tires, you get the 4th tire free instantly. Plus, get special financing for 12 months on purchases of $4.99 or more on your Pep Boys credit card. Trust the boys to get you there.
Whatever their stickers say, they'll all lose suction because their filters clog. But with our sonic tips oscillating at 5,000 hertz, only new Dyson Kinetic Science won't lose suction.
Sunday, from the producers of the epic miniseries The Bible, the stunning next chapter critics are calling breathtaking, inspiring. AD will touch your heart. AD, The Bible continues. Then, the thrilling premiere of American Odyssey.
I am an American soldier!
It all starts this Sunday at 9, 8 central on NBC.
Currently in our area, 72 degrees under partly cloudy skies. Today, partly cloudy, high 85. Winds east-southeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Tonight, a few passing clouds. Low 68. Winds southeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Saturday, abundant sunshine. High 86. Southwest winds shifting to east-southeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Never know what's going to happen.
Woo! That was a good one.
I always dreamed of coming here. When my asthma symptoms returned, my doctor prescribed Dulera to help prevent them.
Dulera is for patients 12 and older whose asthma is not well controlled on a long-term asthma control medicine, like an inhaled corticosteroid. Dulera will not replace a rescue inhaler for sudden symptoms.
A 6-month clinical study has shown Dulera helps significantly improve lung function.
Dulera contains formoterol, which increases the risk of death from asthma problems and may increase the risk of hospitalization in children and adolescents. Dulera is not for people whose asthma is well controlled with a long-term asthma control medicine, like an inhaled corticosteroid. Once your asthma is well controlled, your doctor will decide if you can stop Dulera and prescribe a different asthma control medicine, like an inhaled corticosteroid. Do not take Dulera more than prescribed. See your doctor if your asthma does not improve or gets worse.
Ask your doctor about Dulera.
10 minutes after the hour. Glad you're with us on AMHQ. We're covering all the weather in the country this morning, and there is a lot to cover. Live picture this morning of Huntington, West Virginia. Good morning, Huntington, at 57 degrees right now. You've got a little light rain that's kind of in the area, but as Jim pointed out, this is one of the directions that the storms will be moving. Later on today, we'll probably cap off near around 71 degrees when those thunderstorms start slamming around. So heads up there. Hey, let's look at Washington, D.C. this morning. D.C.'s already got some showers and light rain in the area. We're at 66 degrees today. D.C., it's not unlikely you'll get a little rain continuing through the day today, and maybe even a little rumble of thunder. We're talking about 76 degrees today. The good news is that it all kind of gets out of the way by the time we're headed into the weekend. D.C., 57 degrees, sunny, a little gusty wind is what's waiting for you by the time we get to Saturday. Jen, a lot of folks are going to be talking about these warm temperatures, and they're all coming from the south. I'm looking at the colors behind you.
Yeah, you see all that. And you're excited, too, because we're going to be looking at temperatures in the 80s. You have friends in town and family, and we're all going to be enjoying the warm temperatures in the southeast. But the problem is we have a front that's coming through, and that's going to drop those numbers back down. As we show you, numbers running almost 10 to 15 degrees above average. Look at Raleigh and Atlanta showing off with a high today of 82 degrees. Spectacular. Let's move this ahead and show you what's going to be going on as we look into the holiday weekend. By tomorrow, high of 66 degrees. That's that cooler air. The winds coming from the north, dropping our numbers back down to 66 in Atlanta, 61 in Knoxville, and 53 degrees in New York City for your Saturday. Looking ahead for the weekend, shapes up like this. Pittsburgh, rain around for you, and Syracuse, 62 degrees and sunshine. I know today's Good Friday, a lot of people going out for a Passover service. And then Saturday and Sunday for Pittsburgh, you're going to have sunshine out there, cool on Saturday, and then Sunday, high of 61 degrees. Now we break it down for Portland, Maine. Well, Portland, you're going to be looking at windy conditions as well as cooler temperatures. Here is the weekend forecast for Boston, New York, and Washington, D.C. Notice windy conditions. Might even see some of those winds getting to wind advisory status for New York. We'll see some of those wind gusts up to potentially about 30 miles per hour. And then on Sunday, you warm up with 61 degrees and 68 degrees for Boston. So the numbers aren't looking so bad. We just have to get through tomorrow. And everybody wants, you know, the weather to be nice for Easter, especially for all the kiddies that are going out and looking for those eggs out there. I mean, that was big fun back then.
Yeah, it is big fun. I still remember it. I like the coloring of the eggs. I like getting the dye all over your hands, except for that vinegary smell.
Yeah.
I'm sure that's taken care
of
that now. I'm sure that's
and
all much better now.
With
a little wire back in the old days.
Your fingers are all blue.
All right. Yeah. We've got a lot of images today of folks who are trying to clean up after the flooding today. And from these flooded zones, you can actually see the fire in many of these locations because it's all happening many places south of Louisville. Ashley Lee was kind enough to spend some time with us several times this morning talking about the flooding that was going on in her apartment building. Ashley's home is on the second floor, but early this morning she heard an awful lot of commotion outside, got us some pictures of the flooding up to the car windows and beyond in her parking lot and the damage on the first floor of there. Anna Rittis?
Sam, this flooding happening everywhere in Louisville. Let's track for you the latest developments. This is what we know now. Gridlock across the city. High water causing widespread road closures. You heard from emergency officials, at least 36 roads are closed at this hour. Interstate 65 now open after being closed for a time at the Waterson Expressway and I-264. Mudslides reported in Spout Springs near the Powell County line. Over 100 high water rescues around the city this morning. One person was confirmed dead after a tree fell on a tent at a campsite in Powell County, Kentucky. The campground has been evacuated due to flash flooding. Also evacuated, people on the first floors of Guardian Court Apartments, a rescue team going door to door by boat to get people out. Meantime, emergency crews are at a massive 6-alarm fire at the GE Appliance Park in Louisville. More than 100 firefighters working to put out this blaze. Buildings there evacuated. Dark black smoke, Sam, could be seen 4 miles.
6,000 people work at that plant. Appliance Park is a 1,000-acre complex. We know it's building 6 at this area. We'll continue to follow that story, possibly touched off by lightning.
Linux makes the quietest system you can find. So even though it's the most powerful force in your home, it won't sound like it is.
For more information, contact your local Linux dealer.
Constipated? Dulcolax tablets can cause cramps, but not Phillips. It has magnesium and works more naturally than stimulant laxatives for gentle cramp-free relief of occasional constipation.
That works.
Mm-hmm. Live the regular life. Phillips.
Oh, man. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
You're covered, Harry. Man.
You gotta do it like this. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Hey, George.
Hey, Jim.
State Farm agents are there whenever you need them.
Oh, this audit will take days. What a headache.
Actually, I don't have a headache anymore. Except it really does work fast.
Quiet! Mom has a headache!
Had a headache, but now I don't.
With 2 pain fighters plus a booster, Excedrin ends headaches fast. In fact, for some, relief starts in just 15 minutes.
Oh, my headache's gone. Not gonna happen.
Excedrin.
Wow, that was fast.
It can be hotter than Death Valley in your attic.
But that's still not hot enough to sweat out bugs. Take these boxes. They're not only perfect for storing old yearbooks and pictures.
You find something?
They're also a perfect food source and nesting material for roaches. That's why I identify their favorite snacks, like old books, clothing, wood.
Then I seal entryways and use the latest scientific methods.
Orkin, pest control down to a science.
Can a protein originally found in a jellyfish improve your memory? Our scientists say yes. Researchers have discovered a protein that actually supports healthier brain function. It's the breakthrough in a supplement called Prevagen. As we age, we lose proteins that support our brain. Prevagen supplements these proteins and has been clinically shown to improve memory. It's safe and effective. For support of healthier brain function, a sharper mind, and clearer thinking, try Prevagen for yourself today.
We are still in the eye, and we're still trying to get in the same place.
She's in labor right now.
We know more about this system hour by hour.
This is our Pineapple Express pumping in that rainfall.
We are talking about a doozy of a storm.
Hi, I'm Jeannie Francis, and like many of you, I've struggled with my weight and made a lot of great excuses, but no more. I tried Nutrisystem and I lost 10 pounds, then 20, then 30, and I realized I can do this.
Lose weight fast with Nutrisystem's Fast 5 Plus Kit. Lose 5 pounds in your first week, plus 1 inch off your waist or your money back, guaranteed.
I'm Jeannie Francis, and I lost 30 pounds with Nutrisystem. Nutrisystem is so simple. I don't have to count or measure, and the food is really good.
Order your 28-day Nutrisystem plan right now, including Fast 5 Plus. Get 1 week of specially selected meals, plus 1 week of energizing shakes free, and 1 week of Craving Crusher shakes free.
Take the drama out of losing weight. You can do this. Call or click right now.
Call 877-699-SIZE right now and get Fast 5 Plus with shakes free.
Oh. You just never know what's going to happen.
Woo! That was a good one.
currently. Today, sunshine and clouds mixed. High 84. Winds east-southeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Tonight, a few passing clouds, otherwise generally clear. Low 68. Winds southeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Saturday, abundant sunshine. High 86. Southwest winds shifting to east-southeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
All right, just when we thought we were going to get through the morning a little on the quiet side in terms of severe weather, we've got a little surge in our bow echo this morning right around the Cairo area and heading over toward Paducah. This warning is for Ballard and Carlisle counties. Watch out again in Blandville, Cunningham, and Wickliffe. We have a surge in this bow. We could produce 70-mile-per-hour winds with this. Let's advance ahead because there's a couple of interesting things on this as we look at the high-resolution radar. Now, so you can see the whole bow here, but it's got some waves to it, and those little waves are kind of interesting. We like to watch those because what's happening, of course, is air is surging into and away from those. And where it surges away is where you get those gusty winds. Some of this may even rotate briefly here, so we have to watch that for quick spin-ups with that. But here you can see the air is coming in and then sweeping in behind that pretty quickly. Brandon, go in pretty tight on this. First of all, you can see where the air is coming. And remember, this is the wind part of the radar that shows the air coming in and away from the site. So the surge in the bow is right here, right along Highway 51 coming into the southwest of Blandville and Cunningham. Spread out here a little bit, Brent. I want to show this other area because down to the southwest in that, there's a couple other areas that bear interest south of Anniston in through here and also near the New Madrid area. So we've got a couple of little spots on this line now that are starting to surge a little bit. Winds possibly as high as 70 miles per hour. Paducah, be on alert because that surge is definitely coming your way. All right, within this whole complex is Mike Seidel in Cape Girardeau. And Mike, tell us about what you're seeing in the Cape Girardeau area now.
Yeah, Jim, we had those storms come through, a lot of lightning, some heavy rain, no hail, little if any wind. The winds are dead calm, but proof positive, Jim, based on what you see on the radar. Look at this, the back edge of the storms and the severe weather. Look at all the blue sky out there. And in the distance, you can see some of the cumulus clouds being hit by the sun as the sun comes up here in mid-America. So we've got clearing coming in, but we're still on the other side of the front. So we've got to get that through. That may pop some more showers. We had some great mammatus clouds about 5 or 10 minutes ago. They've now dissipated. Maybe you can, I don't know if you can make them out over the hotel here, Jim, but we had some great looking mammatus clouds. Boy, that's twice in now, what, about 8 days for yours truly. Not too shabby. Jim, back to you.
All right, Michael, we appreciate that. Definitely get ready for some more rain this afternoon as the cold front comes through, and that should certainly be the end of it. After that, for everybody, it gets a chance to dry out. Very, very wet part of the country over the last 30 days and really over the last couple of months as well. So let's check out Louisville here. We all know what's going on. You see the rain move through earlier this morning, and left over was this little plume here that's been the fire. Now some more rain has moved on in. But I want to split the screen here, Lisa, and so everybody can see the fire live from our friends at Wave TV in Louisville, as well as see the smoke plume that's still going on here. This is still live pictures. My goodness, look at that smoke plume. So there's rain coming down through that, and I have to think that it's picking up some of that ash and dropping it down. This is, again, the GE fire in Louisville. This is a huge plant. It's one of the biggest in the country. The building that started the fire was the building number 6, we think, right now being used for a storage facility. But there is all sorts of stuff in each one of those buildings, and they're hoping to get this contained. It is either now at this point a 6 or 7 alarm fire, which is causing the efforts of about 100 plus firefighters here in the Louisville area. All right, Brandon, let's go in a little bit. So I'm going to let you control this from now on so we can get in and look at some of the pictures. Now, notice initially when the fire went up, the smoke plume was going off to the north and west because we had a southeast surface wind. Ahead of the approaching cold front, our winds are shifting now a little bit more out of the south. So we're seeing the smoke plume actually come back up into the city limits of Louisville. All right. So we're seeing that plume. And, of course, with rain coming down, some of this is obviously falling out of the sky. Now, I don't know what, again, that ash is made of. But if you've got a respiratory issue, you don't want to be breathing this stuff. I can promise you that. Respiratory or not, you probably don't want to be breathing what is coming in out of this smoke plume. Again, a little bit of a better concentration of it. It looks like it's up through Audubon Park, down through the Newburgh area. That's probably the meat of the smoke plume now. The correlation coefficient can also pick this up. Remember, this looks at equal-sized droplets, raindrops. Drops will all appear as red, but when you have smoke, that's a different size, and it shows up just like tornado debris does in a tornado signature. We'll be right back.
Andrew, Rita, Sandy, meet Chris, Jackie, Joe. Minor damage or major disaster? When you need us most, we're there. State Farm. We're a force of nature, too.
I smoked a lot and quit a lot, but ended up nowhere. Now I use this.
The Nicoderm CQ patch with unique extended-release technology helps prevent the urge to smoke.
To be my last time. That's why I choose Nicoderm CQ.
What do you think?
When I first sit in the seat, it makes me think of a BMW.
I feel like I'm in a Lexus.
You would think that this was a brand new Audi.
It's like a luxury car.
It feels kind of like an Infiniti.
Very similar to Range Rover.
This is pretty high tech.
Yeah, it is. It reminds me of the Mercedes.
This is Chevy?
Wow.
I have a new appreciation for Chevy.
They thought about me.
I could totally rock this.
This thing feels pretty
cool.
This is the jam.
Pretty bomb, dude.
Maybe I will go Chevy.
I'm definitely in.
Happy birthday!
Make a wish, buddy. Okay, now Mom's gonna cut the cake.
We all have a Disney side.
Who wants ice cream?
And the best place to show it is Disney Parks. So come to the place where the entire family can laugh, let loose, and play together. Disney Parks. Come on, it's time to show your Disney side.
Switch to Cricket Wireless this tax season and get a free 4G LTE smartphone after mail-in rebate and a free month of service after completing 2 months on select plans. That way you can turn your tax refund into a me fund and treat yourself to something nice, like every flavor and every topping. Cricket, something to smile about.
The termite swarm has come. Enter the legions of Terminix with 85 years of experience and the strongest guarantee in the business. Sorry, termites. We got our swarm of our own. Not here. Not now. Not in my house. Terminix.
Introducing the new Can-Am Spyder F3. With a cruising riding position and the most advanced vehicle stability system in the industry, you'll ride with a feeling of complete freedom and confidence. Visit your Can-Am Spyder dealer and test drive one today. The new Spyder F3. Riding has evolved.
You know those neighbors always making weird inventions out of junk in their garage? We just gave them their own TV show.
I think I just made Mother Nature my bitch.
One man's trash.
This is perfect.
Is another man's wood-powered Jeep gasifier.
Brainstormers, Sundays at 9, only on the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 77 degrees under partly cloudy skies. Today, sunshine and clouds mixed. High 84. Winds east-southeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Tonight, a few passing clouds, otherwise generally clear. Low 68. Winds southeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Saturday, abundant sunshine. High 86. Southwest winds shifting to east-southeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
have been shattering records. Look at this, Sam.
I'm getting soaked.
You weren't expecting that, were you?
No, I wasn't.
Minutes after the hour on this Friday. A lot of folks celebrating Passover or observing Passover today, celebrating Good Friday today. And boy, what an active weather day this has been for us.
Yeah, we're talking about the flooding as well as the fires that we've seen out there across parts of Kentucky. And the severe weather is not done yet, Sam.
Yeah, no, it's been roaring this morning. You're looking at the damaging hail images that we had, the flooding that kind of lit up this morning around southern Louisville area and made a run across northern Kentucky, really, all the way into Frankfort, then making a way into Lexington, then continuing on east toward West Virginia. We also have the tornado threat. A lot of that across northern Arkansas. We've been watching those storms move through the boot heel of Missouri and into western Tennessee this morning. Just a quick recap, we also are watching the fire that is going on at the GE complex in Louisville, Kentucky. That appliance park is about a 1,000-acre headquarters of the GE Consumer and Industrial Division there. About 6,000 people work in this building. We don't have any idea who was in the building at the time this fire broke out. Haven't had any reports of anyone being inside or anyone injured in this fire.
Off from what it be here.
Right. For Jim, so you're saying it was a holiday and that's why
Friday.
Everybody was off?
Yes.
Okay, so what we do know is this fire was touched off very early this morning as a complex of storms moved through with very active lightning. Jim has walked us through the radar to show us the lightning that was over that area.
Ash has been reported nearby at the airport. People have been sending pictures all morning, seeing the plumes of smoke from miles away, as much as 5 miles away. And GE Appliance Park is trending on Twitter right now. We know that at least 6 engines are responding to this fire. More than 100 firefighters are trying to get this blaze under control at this time. As Jim mentioned, rain is in the area at this point. Maybe that can help, Jim.
All right, and we're also going to watch that line of thunderstorms move back through that area. The wind becomes a little bit more powerful. Jen, one of the things that I got to say, we need to turn our direction a little bit toward the West Coast.
Right.
And we've got a kind of a break in the way of maybe some moisture coming in the next couple of days toward the West.
Yeah, absolutely. We're going to be looking at periods of heavy rainfall moving to the West. Right now, we start off across parts of the midsection, then we go out to the West. A big dramatic difference there. Nothing showing up on the radar, but we are going to start to see things change. And what we have is this trough that is actually going to be bringing in the potential for some much needed precipitation. And this came out yesterday, the information from the U.S. Drought Monitor showing you, yes, much of the state of California in extreme drought. You see it in the red, and really the folks there are seeing red. They desperately need the rainfall. So here comes finally that change that we've been talking about, the dip in the jet stream. And this is going to mean more potential precipitation there in the form of rain and, dare I say, even some snow right along the Sierras. Here's what we're looking at for the next week. We're not just talking about one day. We're going to see several days of some much needed rainfall coming. Mountain snow setting up anywhere you're seeing in pink. We'll add it into areas including parts of Washington as well as into Oregon. And then for Monday, still holding on to the rain showers, but we're going to see it for Redding as well as for areas like San Francisco as well as into parts of the mountains, the Sierra, getting some of that snowfall. We showed you yesterday really just the devastating images of how barren those mountains are with no snow out there. But as we go through the next 10 days, it doesn't sound like a lot, but we're talking some of these locations, 2 to 3 inches. We're even going to see some of this rain working its way down to Southern California where they desperately need it. We're talking LA as well. San Francisco, here's your forecast as we show you for Sunday. Yes, this is Easter Sunday. You're going to be starting up your morning with some rain out there. That means Easter Bunny is going to be getting a little wet out there. And then on Monday, 60 degrees, and then we'll see the chance of rain, and then we dry things out. But not everybody's forecast is going to look like this across parts of California. Some areas are going to see several periods of some rainfall.
All right, you've got a little advance notice on this. Trap that rain, hold that rain, barrel that rain, do anything you can, Jim, because we've got the opportunity of getting that moisture into the West Coast. Still, active storms to track. Mr. Cantore's the dude to do it.
Let's talk about this. Again, I go back to this smoke plume to the south of Louisville here. You can see it clearly on the radar. When we didn't have any precipitation, now light rain has moved in. Maybe something positive here, Sam, in the fact that we've lost some of the intensity in that smoke. That could just mean, though, that we're seeing less ash or bigger chunks of ash versus the fact that we still have a fire going on, which we can clearly see by the pictures here. It is still absolutely raging. Over 100 firefighters on this one, and the smoke is now shifted a little bit, the wind direction. It's come from the southeast to a little bit more southerly, so it's bringing that smoke back up toward Louisville. All right, I want to go back to earlier this morning because before the fire, which I'll put a a little pin on there for you. You can watch it. As this loops around, you can see earlier this morning the tremendous amounts of lightning. Now, it has not been confirmed if lightning did this, but certainly one could argue that it may have because of the kind of lightning that we see. So look at how the rain moves through and ends, and then all of a sudden, boom! There's that fire showing up, and here comes the new rain in. We've lost a little bit of the intensity there of that fire. Hopefully, that's a good trend. All right, the severe thunderstorm warnings that we have for you, Ballard, Carlisle, just about to end there. But down to the southeast, we've seen a new warning come out, again, for Carlisle, Southern Carlisle, and also Graves County. Let's go to the high resolution, Brandon, and you advance this for me, because I want to show you something. Sometimes you have to watch out for these, because where you see, again, some of the reflectivity that we have out there, we can say that we've got a pretty strong area of wind also coming toward Paducah. So right now, I see two areas of wind that I would worry about down to the south. And you can see we may see this northern warning advanced on for Paducah a little bit later on as that cell heads out. So, Sam, we're not out of the woods yet. There you see the reflectivity with that. Don't be surprised if some of that wind also comes up and toward Paducah. These things tend to kind of wrap around like little curls when they gust out. Winds could be as high as 70 miles per hour.
All right. Good to know, Jim. Thank you. All that headed toward Lone Oak and also crossing the land between the lakes not too long from now. So if you know folks who are out vacationing there, just make sure they get the heads up. In Nashville, which is just south of the area Jim just lined out for you, there is the potential of these storms and more storms developing in that area. Our Dave Malkoff is there right now. Hey, good morning, Dave. What do you see?
Good morning, Sam. Something is changing and something is coming here in Music City. You can literally feel the change in the air. It's gotten cooler. There's a little bit of drizzle now. Let me show you the sky back here. You can see it come in through those bridges back there, the Sigintala Bridge over downtown Nashville. Now, this is going to be a storm that's changing as we go out through the day. We were thinking that at 8 a.m. we would see the major part of the storm here. 8 a.m. has come and gone Central Time. So now we're thinking it's going to start at 10 a.m. Central Time and push through, this is a long one, until 1 a.m. So this is a long one throughout the day, Sam. We're going to have a possibility of damaging hail, possibility of high winds. We're talking 35 to 40 mile an hour gusts. So this is a major storm coming through here. We see it. It's kind of on its last train from Clarksville coming this way. Yeah. But we see it's coming towards us, Sam.
Last train from Clarksville. I got it, Dave. Okay. Also, make sure you've got a safe place for cover because the kind of lightning we saw move through Mike Seidel's shot is exactly what you're in for as it moves through. Let's get caught up on the headlines today. Ana Reyes Rodriguez has all the details.
Good morning, Sam. Good morning to you at home. Let's get you ahead of your Friday morning headlines. The U.S. and other world powers now have a framework for a deal to limit Iran's nuclear program. President Obama says the deal would keep nuclear plants open, but under strict production limits and inspections. Lawmakers from both parties have demanded congressional input on a final agreement. Reuters reporting the EPA is blocking the use of certain pesticides so the agency can further assess the risk that it has to bees. The pesticides are routinely used in agriculture and on plants and trees and gardens and in parks. Some farmers and nursery owners say the insecticides are crucial in combating pests that destroy crops and other plants. And a man reported missing at sea more than 2 months is back on land this morning. Lewis Jordan says he drank rainwater and caught fish to survive. The mast on his boat broke and a storm damaged his radio after he set sail from South Carolina in January. A ship spotted him Thursday 200 miles off the coast of North Carolina and picked him up. The Coast Guard airlifted him to a Virginia hospital. Jordan's family calls his rescue a miracle, Sam.
It truly is. It's hard to believe he was able to survive that. We're going to talk to students, families, folks who woke up this morning, had to be evacuated, were under the flooding rains in Kentucky.
Today, sunshine and clouds mixed. High 84. Winds east-southeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Tonight, a few passing clouds, otherwise generally clear. Low 68. Winds southeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Saturday, abundant sunshine. High 86. Southwest winds shifting to east-southeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
You can't predict the market, but at T. Rowe Price, we've helped guide our clients through good times and bad. Our experienced investment professionals are one reason over 85% of our mutual funds beat their 10-year Lipper averages. So in a variety of markets, we can help you feel confident. Request a prospectus or summary prospectus with investment information, risks, fees, and expenses to read and consider carefully before investing. Call us or your advisor. T. Rowe Price. Invest with confidence.
He says she's an undisciplined overwaterer. She claims he's a cruel underwaterer. With Miracle-Gro Moisture Control Potting Mix, plants only get water when they need it. Fight ended or shifted. Miracle-Gro. Life starts here.
Wow, sweet new Subaru, huh, Mitch?
Yep.
You're selling the Mitchmobile?
Man, we had a lot of good times in this baby. What'd your dad want for it?
Like 150 grand.
200 if they want that tape deck. You're not gonna tell your dad about the time my hamster had babies in the back seat, are you?
That's just normal wear and tear, dude.
Subaru has the highest resale value of any brand, according to Kelley Blue Book. And Mitch. Love. It's what makes a Subaru a Subaru.
It's happening. Today, more and more people with type 2 diabetes are learning about long-acting Levemir, an injectable insulin that can give you blood sugar control for up to 24 hours. And Levemir helps lower your A1C. Levemir comes in FlexTouch, the only pre-filled insulin pen with no push-button extension. Levemir lasts 42 days without refrigeration. That's 50% longer than Lantus, which lasts 28 days.
Today, I'm asking about Levemir FlexTouch.
Levemir is a long-acting insulin used to control high blood sugar in adults and children with diabetes and is not recommended to treat diabetic ketoacidosis. Do not use Levemir if you are allergic to any of its ingredients. The most common side effect is low blood sugar, which may cause symptoms such as sweating, shakiness, confusion, and headache. Severe low blood sugar can be serious and life-threatening. Ask your doctor about alcohol use, operating machinery, or driving. Other possible side effects include injection site reactions. Tell your doctor about all medicines you take and all of your medical conditions. Check your blood sugar levels. Your insulin dose should not be changed without asking your doctor. Get medical help right away if you have trouble breathing, swelling of your face, tongue, or throat, sweating, extreme drowsiness, dizziness, or confusion.
Today's the day to ask your doctor about Levemir FlexTouch, covered by nearly all health insurance and Medicare plans.
Carpools, conferences, microwave dinners. They blur one into the next. We lose ourselves in the fog of everyday life and drift away from what matters. But like a beacon in the night, it finds us. The light of more than 100 lighthouses burning through that fog and beckoning us back to what's real and true. This light shines for us all. This light is Pure Michigan. Your trip begins at Michigan.org.
Need an oil change? Right now at Pep Boys, get 5 quarts of Castrol GTX oil and a Purelator Classic filter for only $22.99. Or let the boys do it for you with a full-service conventional oil change for just $24.99 with coupon. Trust the boys to get you there.
Anyone have occasional constipation, diarrhea, gas, bloating?
Yes.
One Philips Colon Health probiotic cap each day helps defend against these occasional digestive issues with 3 types of good bacteria. Live the regular life. Philips.
I got an alert on my phone that said flood warning or flood something, and I'm like, oh, nothing will happen, because no one ever thinks it'll happen, and then it happened.
Yeah, it happened big time in Louisville. Parts of the area underwater. 116 people have been rescued as heavy rain has led to flooding. Now, 5.7 inches came down the last 24 hours officially at the airport. Now, roads are closed, and so are county roads, but or should say county schools. We have reports of some of those underpasses. They had roughly between 6 and 8 feet of water. Now, let's take you over to our wall. We want to talk more about the flooding that's been setting up in Louisville. This is an image coming in from us from the University of Louisville. Now, when you look at the photo here, this is on a good day. This is what's happened right now across parts of Louisville from earlier this morning. Now, we want to zoom into the sign to show you part of the problem with Louisville right now. Do not enter when flooded. That is what the sign says, and this is why it's so important not to go on those flooded roadways. Keep in mind, it only takes 2 feet to basically lose control of your car, and we're also talking about an SUV. Let's look at the radar right now and notice that we do have flash flood warnings in place. We had them across Louisville. Now they're more over towards the east as the storms push over in that easterly direction. But we also have a severe thunderstorm warning in effect. Now this right now is going to go until 9 a.m. What we're going to be looking at are some of those strong winds where the lines kind of been bowing out. We've had some reports of some of those winds right around 50 miles per hour for some of those gusts right now, even for Paducah. So keep that in mind if you're on the roadways. And then we look up towards the north. You can still see that rain moving through parts of southern and central Illinois, making its way over towards the east. Now, we do have flash flood watches out there really through the afternoon. I should say flood watches. So this means some of those roadways will still potentially be rather dangerous driving through as we go throughout the morning and even the afternoon with more storms firing up.
Yeah, definitely still some trouble out there. So Pikeville, London, if you're in Reedland or Lone Oak, make sure you send us those pictures. Mm-hmm. Everyone's been sending pictures in. Imagine what it's like in the morning. All of a sudden, you're deep at sleep and this storm starts pouring. More than 5.25 inches of rain. Now, that's the real report. Many Doppler estimates are up to 8 inches of rain. Now, a lot of things are shut down, and it certainly puts a cramp in your life on a Friday. So let's talk to some folks who were involved in it. Sydney Williams is a freshman at U of L. Hey, Sydney, are you there? Good morning.
Hello.
Hi, how are you doing? How's your family? Everybody okay?
Yeah, we're making it.
Okay, now I know that, you were getting up and getting ready to go to classes, certainly, but walk me through when you guys realized this morning that there was heavy rain going on and your house was even getting a little flooded.
Yeah, there was. When I woke up, we probably had about maybe 5 to 6 inches of standing water, so I had to try and move my car to the center of the driveway where it would be the safest, that way it wouldn't flood. And then we come in the house to find that our sump pump's not working properly, and now our basement has about 8 inches of standing water in it right now too.
Sydney, I'm so sorry about it. Now, in there, your family's all there. Is your mom, Jennifer, your grandmom, Teresa, and your little brother, Aiden, you guys all live together, right?
Yes, we do.
Okay, now, so what are the plans now? What are you guys going to have to do to try to get rid of some of that water this morning?
They are actually outside right now working on trying to clear off the drains, and I think they've gotten it cleared out enough and the water's gone down enough to where we can try and move our car out.
All right, now, you're a freshman at U of L, and you're going into criminal justice, I think, right?
Yes, that's what I'm planning on doing.
All right, good for you, young lady. Let's talk a little bit about how you got information from U of L. All your classes are canceled today?
No, actually, they delayed us until 10 o'clock, but since my driveway and the part of the street where I would need to get out was flooded, I couldn't make it.
All right, Sydney. Hey, we're hoping for the best for you and the family. I know you've got another round of storms this afternoon. On the My Weather end of this bit, the only thing I can tell you is as we're showing you the day part of your forecast, there are more storms today, but Saturday and Sunday are both dry and sunny days. 61 on Saturday, 69 on Sunday. Sydney Williams, a freshman at U of L, lives in Louisville, and her home is flooded this morning. Sydney, thank you for taking some time with us. Easter weekend, we should be talking about sunshine, but we've got more than that going on for parts of the Northeast. You're going from a warm, luscious day today all the way into the snowmaker. And we want to salute our backyard hero this morning. Check out a human football, wait a minute, foosball table, sorry, in Brownton, Minnesota. Several volunteers from Brownton Area Resources for Kids got together to build this foosball table so they could hold a tournament as a fundraiser. Now, again, when you operate the bar, usually you make people kick, but they're holding onto the bar and kicking. Michelle Jerebik shot the video and practiced around on her cell phone.
This program brought to you by True Green. Start your True Green lawn plan today. True Green, live life outside.
True Green presents The Yardleys.
Drives down the lane. Beautiful.
Oh, come on.
To the big man underneath.
Come on, he's in the pink there.
Gets it up off the glass and it's in for two.
This is more than a lawn. This is a True Green lawn. Live life outside with True Green, America's number one lawn care company. Spring is on. Start your True Green lawn plan today. True Green, live life outside.
You know those neighbors always making weird inventions out of junk in their garage? The Weather Channel just gave them their own TV show.
Gonna be awesome! Oh!
Sunday nights.
Come on, wind.
I think I just made Mother Nature my bitch.
One man's trash.
This is perfect.
Is another man's wood-powered Jeep gasifier.
This is incredible.
Failure's not an option.
Whoa, 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 whoa.
Oh, yeah, it is.
We got a problem, Houston.
Brainstormers, Sunday nights at 9, only on the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 78 degrees under partly cloudy skies. Today, sunshine and clouds mixed, high 84. Winds east-southeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Tonight, a few passing clouds, otherwise generally clear, low 68. Winds southeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Saturday, abundant sunshine, high 86. Southwest winds shifting to east-southeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Whatever their stickers say, they'll all lose suction because their filters clog. But with our sonic tips oscillating at 5,000 Hz, only new Dyson Kinetic Science won't lose suction.
I'd like to put in my 15-year notice.
You're quitting?
Technically retiring, sir. With a little help from my State Farm agent, I plan to retire in 15 years.
Wow, you're totally blindsiding me here. Who's going to manage your accounts? This is a devastating blow I was not prepared for.
Take charge of your retirement. Talk to a State Farm agent today.
Why do we do it? Why do we spend every waking moment thinking about people? Why are we so committed to keeping you connected? Why combine performance with a conscience? Why innovate for a future without accidents? Why do any of it? Why do all of it? Because if it matters to you, it's everything to us. The XC60 crossover from Volvo. Lease the well-equipped Volvo XC60 today. Visit your local Volvo showroom for details.
She watched him being tortured and killed. Moment by moment.
You think he's coming back?
Where's your son?
Not here. There's so much danger to spare. That's why my son came to us.
AD, the Bible continues Sunday on
Habitat for Humanity of Palm Beach County is a nonprofit organization dedicated to bringing people together to build safe, decent, affordable housing to serve low-income and hard-working families in our community. You can help Habitat's mission through home sponsorship, monetary donations, volunteering, or by donating sellable household items and building supplies to our restores. You can learn more at habitatpbc.org.
It's a little known fact that when you whip up a bowl of smooth, buttery, Hungry Jack mashed potatoes on fish stick night, they'll honor you with a moment of silence. Award-winning Hungry Jack mashed potatoes.
With so many luscious layers, Edwards pies are one of the great wonders of the world. The colossus of creamy layers, the Taj Mahal of taste. Incredibly indulgent cream pies from Edwards, the luscious wonders of the world.
Sundays.
One man's trash
did the work.
Is another man's totally awesome beer can space heater.
Hi.
Brainstormers, Sundays at 9, only on the Weather Channel.
52 minutes after the hour right here on AMHQ. Glad you're with us this morning, a morning of breaking news and breaking weather as we wake you up across the country. We're taking you to Aspen, Colorado this morning, and you can watch everyone in this camera kind of work their way up toward the slope. Traffic's moving. Everybody's up and running. We got a chilly morning with temperatures in the low 20s right now. There is a freeze warning in effect, and there's some fresh powder on the ground. Not a lot, but a little. That's a good thing. Now, that system is headed east. How much snow and how much rain will be blended in on an Easter weekend snowmaker? Well, let's get caught up with Tom Nizzle this morning and we'll get all the answers. Good morning, Tom.
Good morning, Sam. Hey, I want to stick with Denver for a second here. We're going to show you the radar. They picked up about 6 inches of snow in places like Estes Park, a place that I absolutely love. But here's the snow right now, and it is beginning to wind down across the area. There have been some slick roads. But once again, as we get into Denver for Easter Sunday, we're going to see a temperature of 70 degrees. Now, let's take a look at how this system moves out. This jet energy here in the atmosphere is not only producing that severe weather we're seeing in Kentucky right now, but it is going to move that precipitation up into New England as we get into the weekend. Let me show you how that works here. We get into a flow here with northerly flow from the jet stream here that is going to keep cold air across northern New England Sunday, and this will continue into the week, even into the Tuesday time frame. So we're going to show you how the rain is going to move here into western New York as we go through the evening. Buffalo starts out with rain here, but watch this system as it heads to the northeast. It taps a little bit colder air across upstate New York and northern New England here, and in fact, it's going to be cold enough at higher elevations to see several inches of snow. The other thing that's going to come up with this are the winds. The winds are going to get very blustery out of a northwest direction Saturday and into Saturday afternoon. Actually, in parts of the Adirondacks, they could gust over 40 miles an hour. The good news, the system moves off pretty quickly Saturday afternoon. We get another little clipper that comes in Sunday morning here, and you can see this first is rain across western New York. This is Easter Sunday afternoon, and then a little later in the evening into that cold air again, we are going to see snow develop across the Adirondack Mountains and into portions of northern New England. So that's how it is going to set up. The higher elevations, I consider this what I call an elevation storm south of Buffalo, Adirondack Mountains, into New England, anywhere from 3 to 6 inches of snow, up to 8 inches up near Caribou here. The good news is the southeast coast of New England here likely going to be warm enough to be just a rain event. And in fact, take a look at Buffalo. Buffalo gets most of their snow in the overnight hours tonight. By tomorrow morning, it's going to be cold for the eastern egg hunts, but at least you're going to be able to get out without too much in the way of precipitation. And finally, we ride the roller coaster in Boston from 66 today to that rain on Saturday. We might see an afternoon shower Easter Sunday, and then unfortunately getting into Tuesday, one more bout of colder weather, possibly a little rain and snow into New England. Sam, I wish I could give more, but as we get into the latter part of April, I see warmer weather coming for that area as well.
All right, and they're going to want to hear that from you, Tom. Okay, we have had a rocking morning, and you guys have made it possible to cover a lot of this by sending us the pictures. Just a quick update on those.
Flooding, fire, hail, wind damage, 8 reported tornadoes by the Storm Prediction Center, which would be confirmed later on by the National Weather Service. You've been sending us pictures all morning, and they're extremely impressive. This is of the GE fire seen from one side of the city in Louisville. The plumes of smoke are everywhere.
Just want to confirm that the Jefferson County Fire Department has reached out and told us that it is officially a 6-alarm fire. Every fire department in the country ranks these things a little differently depending on how they rank their trucks and units as they move in, but officially being called 6-alarm right now.
Now, this is happening at the GE Appliance Park, which about 6,000 people work there. This is a 1,000-acre park in Louisville. We don't know if people were evacuated, but we do know that there are no injuries at this
time. And
this
building is like, what, 10?
The size of 10 football fields. Yeah. Fog was something else that was happening today
in parts of New York
and parts of Detroit, and this is in Indiana. This particular person always sends us pictures of Niona Lake, and you can see across the lake to the other side.
Normally, on a good day.
This morning, obviously, the fog just blanketing pretty much everything there. Let's head out west. California, good morning to you. Twitter follower is really excited for the rain that's coming on Saturday.
I think everyone is.
We're excited for that Twitter follow.
Yeah, we really are. And Northern California gets into it first, but this is one of those times that we'll get some into Southern California. Show that one. Fear that'll be a good one to go out on.
Jim's geeking out.
Yeah, come on.
Look at this one. This is coming out of Colorado.
Oh,
just a little bit of late spring snow. Identify the
come on, weeping cherry,
Jim? It could be a deciduous magnolia. It could be a cherry. I'm not sure.
Now, are those what are the bushes in front of it? Is that
I can't tell.
I can't tell either. I need close-ups of leaves and flowers.
You, I'd be sneezing.
Looks like a but it's beautiful, isn't it, guys? Yeah. Can we agree on that?
I agree. It's gorgeous. Have an amazing day. We continue now with Maria.
Happy Easter, everybody.
Bye.
Currently in our area, 79 degrees under partly cloudy skies.
today. Sunshine and clouds mixed. High 84. Winds east-southeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Tonight, a few passing clouds, otherwise generally clear. Low 68. Winds southeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Saturday, abundant sunshine. High 86. Southwest. Southeast at 10 to 15 miles per hour. Here's our 7-day outlook.